Let's go now to Raymond in Cincinnati, Ohio, listening on Sacred Heart Radio. Hey, Raymond, you're on the air. Hi.
Hi, thank you for taking my call. I have a question. I think I thought of a pretty clever way of explaining to Protestants or non-Catholics how Mary can mysteriously listen to and answer our prayers, answer many prayers at once.
Great. Lay it on us, Raymond.
So what I was thinking was, since God is infinite, and I'm also hoping you can poke holes in this and see if there are things that I'm saying that are incorrect.
But I will poke holes to the best of my ability.
He's holding a poker, Raymond. Be careful, sir.
Excellent. So God is infinite, and God is, I heard once that God is outside of time, and he can kind of view time in front of him as if it's like just a timeline on a table, and he can look at it and see all of it.
Sure.
And so when Mary went to heaven, since she has an eternal soul, she is in a certain way infinite as well, and we would also be infinite, and so the saints could answer prayers also. This ties into the saints as well, but she would also have that sort of level of infinity. That's kind of one question is, would it be incorrect to say that we are also infinite because we have eternal souls? But then Mary, and this is a part of my second question is...
Raymond, it's Patrick. Can I press pause on the second part? Because we're multiplying elements of the first part. Do we have eternal souls, Jimmy?
Well, we do have eternal souls, and consequently they're infinite in the sense that they go forward for an unlimited amount of time. But that's qualitatively different than the kind of infinitude that God has. God doesn't just go forward in time indefinitely or unlimitedly.
Sure.
Neither does he go back in time unlimitedly. He's eternal in the sense of he's outside of time altogether. And so that's why he can view all of time from what's called the eternal now, which the classic definition of eternity is it's the simultaneous and complete possession of everlasting life. So from his perspective outside of time, God has all of time equally present to him. Mm-hmm. But that's different than the way we experience things, even when we die.
Could you say that the Blessed Mother's hearing and understanding prayers is not just about temporality, namely her immortal soul, but it's also about some share in God's omniscience? It's one thing to exist forever. It's another thing to understand and hear forever.
There's an aspect to that, but I want to make sure that I understand Raymond's claim that he wants me to poke holes in.
Almost done.
Okay.
Okay, so say in terms of infinity, if we look at it as a timeline, Mary will go forward into infinity.
Mm-hmm.
And so if she receives each prayer at once, or if she receives, say, a dozen prayers at the same time,
mm-hmm.
theoretically she would have all of infinity to answer them, all of eternity to answer them one by one by one.
Mm-hmm.
And so... in that sense, since she would have forever to answer them, and she could, now this is a part I'm not sure about, she could view the, like, eternity go forward, I guess. Does it make sense what I'm trying to say?
Well, let me see if I've got a handle on it. It's true that we're all going to have infinite futures, and consequently, if we have more to pray about than we can pray about right now, then we could continue to pray about it in the future. So let's suppose, and just for sake of argument, let's suppose the world ends in the year 3000, okay, just to pick a random number. And suppose Mary has had so many prayers that she can't get to all of them by the year 3000. Well, in the year 4000... she could still be praying for them. And because God is outside of time and the year 4000 is just as present to God as the year 3000 or the year 2000, God could listen to Mary's prayer in the year 4000 and apply it to the person who needed help way back in the year 2000. He can do that because he's outside of time. So what you sketched, if I understand you correctly, is a possible way that God could have the saints pray for things that they wouldn't seem to be humanly able to do. So I can't rule that out. It's possible that God could do it that way if he wanted. But I would also say I don't know that that's the only explanation, because as Patrick alluded to, God enables those in the next life to share in his attributes in different ways. And while we won't ever be omniscient in the way God is, nevertheless, we can have knowledge, and we can have increased intellectual capacity to respond to that knowledge. And so God could also enable Mary to answer all the prayers that are coming to her on an as-needed basis, and give her the knowledge and the cognitive resources needed to do that. So there's more than one explanation. I think what you've identified is a way to where that's possible. And I always say, if we can think of a way that's possible for God to do something, he knows at least that way, and probably a lot of others too. I just wouldn't say that this is the only way, or even necessarily the likely way. I would think that he would probably enable the saints to deal with prayers kind of on an as-needed basis, but it's up to him.
Sure. So just rehashing to make sure that I understood you correctly. A person says a prayer in 2020. Mary doesn't get to it until the year 3000. The person dies in 2025, though. Mm-hmm. That prayer would still theoretically be answered.
Yes,
because
God can apply it to whenever in history it's needed.
Great. I understand that, you know, we won't know completely how it's done, but I think that I like my new understanding of a way to explain it.
Well, I as long as you recognize it's one way, but not necessarily the only way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Does God hear Buzz Lightyear's prayers from infinity and beyond?
Depends. Yes, he does.
Okay.
God hears
if
all
he
prayers.
Falls with style.
Was that very fitting? Raymond, did that poke sufficient holes in your worldview there?
The holes were filled in by other stuff.
Oh, great. Terrific. Well, you can, Jimmy can put down his poker. Put it down, Jimmy.
Okay.
Okay, good, good.
Very good.
We're all safe. Thanks for the call, Raymond.
Bye-bye.
All right. This is, Poking Holes Live, Catholic Answers Live. Jimmy Akin is the guest. He's a senior apologist here at Catholic Answers. He's an author, and I'm looking forward to talking about your book, The Drama of Salvation. Can we do that when it comes out?
Yeah.
Can we do it after it comes out?
Yep.
Can we do it during it coming out?
Yeah, but that's going to require some precise timing.
Because we just did it before it came out, just now.
Yep.
All right. 180.